بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. ڈیئر اسٹوڈینٹس، السلام علیکم. آئی ایم یور ہوسٹ ڈاکٹر ناصر رحمان، اسسٹنٹ پروفیسر. وی ہیو پریپیئرڈ اے برینڈ نیو سیریز آف پروگرامز فار دا کورس بزنس میتھمیٹکس وتھ کورس کوڈ 5405 اینڈ 1429. ٹوڈے یو ول لسن دی 13th پروگرام آف دا سیریز وچ از اباؤٹ یونٹ نمبر 7. And in this program, we will discuss and learn about these topics. Number 1, differentiation of explicit and implicit functions. Number 2, maxima and minima. Number 3, applications of derivatives. Dear students, first of all, we see the definition of explicit function. A function which is given in terms of independent variable is known as explicit function. For example, y is equal to x square plus 3x. Here y is dependent variable and is given in terms of the independent variable x. Now we define implicit function. A function which is given in terms of both the dependent and independent variable is known as implicit function. For example, y plus x square plus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Sometimes it is not convenient to express a function explicitly, such as x square plus y square is equal to 4. Since it could be written as y is equal to 4 minus x square square root, or it can also be written in this form, y is equal to minus 4 minus x square square root. So this is not in the explicit form. Since we have two explicit forms, so it is not in the explicit form, so it is called in the implicit form. Dear students, now we look at an example. Find dy by dx if y square is equal to x square plus sine of xy. First of all, we write it, y square is equal to x square plus sine of xy. Now, differentiating both sides with respect to x, we get d by dx of y square equal to d by dx of x square plus d by dx of sine of xy. Treating y as a function of x and using the chain rule, we get 2y dy by dx is equal to 2x plus cos of xy into d by dx of xy. Now, treating xy as a product and applying the product rule, we get 2y dy by dx is equal to 2x plus cos of xy into y plus x times dy by dx. Dear students, now collecting all the terms involving dy by dx on one side, we get 2y dy by dx minus cos of xy into x dy by dx is equal to 2x plus y times cos of xy. Now taking dy by dx common from the right hand side, we get 2y minus x times cos of xy into dy by dx, and it is equal to 2x plus y cos of xy. Now, dy by dx will be equal to 2x plus y cos of xy divided by 2y minus x cos of xy. Dear students, now we look at another example. Find dy by dx if y is equal to 5x plus cos x. So, first of all, we write y is equal to 5x plus cos of x. Now, differentiating both sides with respect to x, we get dy by dx is equal to d by dx of 5x plus d by dx of cos x. So, dy by dx is equal to 5 into d by dx of x minus the derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Therefore, dy by dx will become dy by dx is equal to 5 minus sin x. Now we look at the definitions of absolute maximum and absolute minimum. absolute maximum. Let f be a function with domain D. Then f has an absolute maximum value on D at a point C if f of x is less than or equal to f of c for all x in the domain D. The second definition is absolute minimum. Let f be a function with domain D. Then f has an absolute minimum value on D at a point C if f of x is greater than or equal to f of c for all x in the domain D. Dear students, now we look at an example. A ball is thrown in the air. Its height at any time t is given by the following function h of t, which is equal to 3 plus 14t minus 5t square. Now we want to calculate that what will be the maximum height of the ball. First of all, using the derivative, we can find the slope of the given function. That is, we write h of t is equal to 3 plus 14t minus 5t square. Now we differentiate it with respect to t. So we get dh by dt is equal to 0 plus 14 minus 10t. Now we calculate the slope of the given equation. The slope of the function at any time t is given by dh by dt is equal to 14 minus 10t. Now we put the slope equal to 0. That is, 14 minus 10t is equal to 0. So we get 10t is equal to 14. That is, we get t is equal to 1.4. The slope is 0 at t is equal to 1.4. And the height at that time will be given by, we put the value of t is equal to 1.4 in the given equation. So we get h of t is equal to 3 plus 14 times 1.4 minus 5 times 1.4 square. So we get h is equal to 3 plus 19.6 minus 9.8. That is, h is equal to 12.8. Therefore, our conclusion is the maximum height will be 12.8 meter and the corresponding time will be 1.4 second. Dear students, now we see another example. Find the absolute maximum and minimum values for the function f of x is equal to x square on the interval minus 2 to 1. The function is differentiable over the entire domain, so only the critical point where f prime of x, which is equal to 2x, will be 0 is the point given by x is equal to 0. Consider the given domain of the function, that is minus 2 to 1. So first of all, we look at the value at x is equal to 0. So f of 0 will be 0. Similarly, at the point x is equal to minus 2, we get f of minus 2, which is minus 2 square, so it is 4. And the value at x is equal to 1 is given by f of 1, which is 1 square, so it is 1. Therefore, the function has an absolute maximum value at x is equal to minus 2 and the absolute minimum value at x is equal to 0. Dear students, now we see another example. A open top box is to be made by cutting small congruent squares from the corners of a 12-inch by 12-inch sheet of tin and bending up the sides. How large should be the squares cut from the corners to make the box hold as much as possible? Dear students, here we are searching for the maximum volume, because if the volume will be maximum, then it will hold as much as possible. Okay, let x be the side of the box. The volume of the box is a function of variable x, that is, volume, which we denote by v of x, is given by x times 12 minus 2x square. So that is, v of x will be equal to 144x minus 48x square plus 4x cube. Since the sides of the sheet of tin are 12 inch long, that is, each side x will be less than or equal to 6. And the domain of v is the interval 0 to 6. That is, x is greater than or equal to 0 and x is less than or equal to 6. The function v of x will be 0 at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 6, and a maximum near x is equal to 2. Now we will differentiate the equation 1, that is, dv by dx is equal to 144 minus 96x plus 12x square. That is, after factorization, we get 12 common. So we get 12 times 12 minus 8x plus x square. Further factorization implies 12 times 2 minus x multiplied by 6 minus x. Now, it is clear that this derivative is 0 at x is equal to 2 and at x is equal to 6. Now, only at x is equal to 2 lies in the interior of the function's domain and makes the critical point. Therefore, the value of v at x is equal to 2 and the domain are 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 6. So, dear students, so we get at x is equal to 2, volume will be 128. At x is equal to 0, v of 0 is 0. And at x is equal to 6, v of 6 is 0. Therefore, our conclusion is the maximum volume is 128 inches cube. Therefore, the cutout squares should be 2 inches on a side. Dear students, that's all for today's program. We hope now that you would definitely have a better understanding of these topics. Next time, we will come to you with the new program. For suggestions, questions, and queries about this program, you are more than welcome to contact our department situated at block number 7, Allama Iqbal Open University, Main Campus, Islamabad. You can also contact us on 051-905-7191. Goodbye and Allah Hafiz.